Welcome to raigurukul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about how to draft or create the Gmail test scenarios. Generally, when we are attempting for the interview process, we have to understand how to write the test scenarios and test cases on several popular sites like Gmail, Yahoo, or any other website. So we'll see here how to create test scenarios for Gmail page. So generally, Gmail page is divided into four parts. One for the sign up page, second will be login page, third is inbox, and fourth is compose email. So we'll try to cover all the scenarios for these pages in detail. So if you are visiting this channel first time, consider subscribing and pressing bell icon for further update. So whenever I will upload a new video, it will get notified to you. So for writing the test scenario, we have to make sure we should complete or cover all the scenarios in detail. While doing sign up page, we have to understand which all fields will be there. So initially, if you can see here, there are two text boxes for the name, one text box for the username, and two text boxes for the password. One is confirm password, and first is create a password. Then we have birthday. These are the drop down list, and here these two are the text box. Then we have drop down list for the gender. Mobile number is again a text box. Then our current email address, and then the locations. And post that, we have this button. So we have to cover each and every field in detail. So let's understand which all scenarios we will have while writing the sign up page scenarios. The first scenario will be to verify all fields are present or not on the page as per the requirement document. So these are the required fields. So generally, if we can see the Gmail sign up page, we will always see this detail will be there. So this will considered as a requirement. So generally, this all fields should be present. Now, next field, to verify all the required fields are marked with asterisk. So generally, when we are doing login or when we are creating a sign up page, few of the fields are very much required. Without that, we cannot proceed it further. So we have to verify this asterisk marks should be there on these type of fields. Next is to verify the better user experience checkboxes. So checkboxes, then text box, drop down list, radio buttons, all should be aligned and within the proper limit. Text available on these type of text boxes should be clear so that user can see properly. So next will be to verify the position of buttons. Next step. So these are the buttons which is at the right aligned. So this button should be clearly visible. Next is to verify after filling all this mandatory field, if the user hits the next tab, that should go to the next page so that when the next page will appear, we have to enter the details or personal detail like enter mobile number or verifications detail. Next is to verify validation messages are displayed as per the input values on the client side. So generally, when we are entering this detail, we should get a validation message. Next, to verify without filling all this mandatory field, are we able to jump into the next page or we are still in the same page with the error message? So that scenario we have to, let's say if I'm not entering the create password and confirm password, I should not go to the next page. It will not allow me to go to the next page. Next is to verify if the user leaves blank some of the optional field, are we able to navigate it to the next page or not? So generally, in that case, if we have the optional field, it will allow us to navigate it to the next page. To verify maximum allowed character or the input field. So here, if you want to check the maximum allowed fields for the input field like text boxes, these are the input fields. Again, username is an input field, create password, confirm password, then mobile number, email address. We have to verify the maximum limit or maximum length limit of these many fields. Next, to verify for the input fields, leading and trailing species is framed automatically. Then to verify if we submit the same request multiple times to the server, are we able to navigate into the, or we are getting an error message. In this type of scenario, generally we should get an error message. So these all scenarios we have to cover it. Apart from that, we can also include the type. So let's say if I'm trying to enter the name and the last name with special character, that should not allow. If I was trying to add username with some non-printable character, that should also not allow. While creating a password should have a strong password, and whenever I'm creating the password, it should not take a simple password like 123 or 124. Then selecting birth date, if I am just entering day and year, I'm not selecting the month, then also that scenario we have to cover it up. Then in gender, without selecting gender, we cannot proceed it further. At the time of adding mobile number, we are not allowed to enter the character here inside this. Then adding email addresses should have the correct format. Then the location, we have to select the particular location. So these all scenario also we have to cover it up. Now let's move to the login page. Generally, while doing in the login activity, we will have these two text boxes, one sign up button, a sign in button, and one checkbox. And at the end, we have one more link or navigation link, which we can see can't access your account or forget a password thing. So to verify all this, the login screen, all the elements like username field, password field, submit button, or sign in button, forward password, links are present, add process specification, documents which we mentioned, and again we should also have the sign in feature checkbox. Next is to verify the cursor is blinking on the email field by default or not. So whenever we will jump into sign in page, if you can see here, that cursor should be inside the username text box. Now, next scenario will be to verify there are email validation functionalities available for the email field or not, or username field. So if I'm just entering the Raikur Cool and without entering that add the read symbol and post that the extension like gmail.com, we are not able to move into the next step. Next is to verify if a user enters an invalid username or password, then user should not be able to log in. To verify validation messages are displayed correctly based on the input values or not. At the time of validation of username and password field, we will get four test cases into it. So generally, first is correct username and password. Second will be wrong username with valid password. Third will be valid username with invalid password. And fourth will be both are invalid. In that case, we are verifying all the scenarios. So again, to verify the password field values are displayed in masked format like asterisks or bullets as per the specified detail via Gmail. So verify there is any limit for the unsuccessful attempts. If you are trying to log in with multiple unsuccessful attempts, that should throw an validation error, like it should throw a captcha related thing by Gmail, or we should also get an options to reset our password. To verify timeout duration for the login screen is to verify the username password field values can copy or not. To verify the right click functionality is disabled or not on the login screen. This is for the Gmail inbox functionality. So let's understand how we will add test cases for the Gmail functionality. To verify the recently received unread email is displayed and highlighted and bold in the inbox screen. So if you can see here, these are the unread email which is highlighted in and will be in bold color, bold. So next will be to verify all the elements of the received email are correctly displayed. So if we are opening any email, we should see sender name, it means to, from and to, then the subject name, body of the message, and if we have any signature or image or attachment, we can see it correctly. Next, to verify when the user clicks on the new email, it redirects to the user to the email content or not. To verify that email contain it displayed in the proper format or not, then again, if you want to verify the attachment store, we have to write the scenarios in such a way like to verify attached documents or the email are downloadable or we cannot be able to download it. So verifying the already read email should not be the highlighted mode. So if you can see here, these are the not read email, these are the read email. So these are not highlighted and we cannot see in the bold. To verify if the count is increased as per the number of emails or new emails has been received, and if that email is spam or any other promotional activity, we can see it into the categorizations. Like if we are getting email or notification from the social media, we will see that notifications available in social media. If we are receiving the email from the promotion things, we can see it into the promotion category. So verify the names are visible to all the users whose names are present in CC and two sections. To verify those names or emails that are present in the BCC sections should not be displayed to other. To verify we can receive email from the other domains like Yahoo, Outlook, Hotmail, Gmail and everything. So totally depending on the domain, all the domains should trigger an email to each other. So we have to verify that as well. Then here we also have multiple sections like move from one folder to the other folder. Next will be to navigate it from one page to the other page. So it will automatically go to the next page. And we have send email options, import, all the sections or menu options should be available. If we are searching for any particular email, we should verify the search box property. Now we have to also verify the read format when and the subject name of that email. So if we are receiving the email today, that should have the today's date. Now next will be compose email. So generally while writing an email, we are moving into the compose email box. So we have to write the scenario for that as well. So generally in Gmail compose email functionality test cases, we have to check all the functionality related details like to, subject, CC, BCC, send, save as draft, discard or add the label. So post entering all this detail, when we are clicking on send email, that should trigger an email to the new person. So to verify this type of things, we have to draft it down Gmail compose email. So first will be to verify when the user click on the compose email button, a new pop-up should display it with the headers as a new message. Next will be to verify the user able to enter email ID in the to, CC and BCC section. Third will be to verify the auto suggestion list of previously entered email ID is displayed or not when filling the email. Next will be to verify multiple commas are allowed to separate multiple email IDs of to, CC and BCC section. Next, to verify the user can enter the subject line in the subject text box. Next scenario will be to verify the user can type in the email body area. So if you can see here, user will be able to do some customizations in terms of text like adding bold, italic, underline. Then we can also add bullets, colors and some smiley. So these options are email. So at the time of writing the email body, that person should be able to use these options as well. So next will be if we want to send the attachment, that user will be able to add the attachment as well as images. So we have to verify that thing as well. Next will be to verify when the user places mouse over on the email ID, then contact information should be displayed. After hitting the send button, the recent sent email should be displayed in the send mail sections. Next, to verify after hitting the send button, the email should be delivered successfully to non-Gmail ID also. To verify after composing the email, if not sent, then that should be stored in the draft sections. To verify that the maximum number of email ID can be added to the two CC and BCC sections. To verify what the maximum number of characters allowed in the email body area is, next, to verify the maximum allowed character in the subject line text box. To verify the maximum size of the attachment file in the email, and if the size will be exceeded, that should go to the G drive sections. To verify the maximum number of attached file in the email, to verify if special characters are entered mistakenly in the 2CC or BCC sections, and when we hit send button, an error message should be displayed. To verify if the subject line is not filled, and when we enter the send button, that time it should display after accepting the pop-up, and the user should be able to enter the subject of the email. So these are the some generic cases. We also have lot many scenarios and test cases for this Gmail body, but generally we are trying to cover the measles scenarios. So that's all from the Gmail test case or scenarios. Hope you enjoyed thing. If think so, this will be useful, then don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.